Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, children. Assalamu alaikum, boys and girls. Inshallah, you have been enjoying these stories from the Holy Quran. I am sure you have. But today, I am here to tell you another story. And this story is about Ayyub. He was a very righteous prophet of Allah. And he is mentioned in the Holy Quran. And he had to go through so many tests, can you believe it? But there is one thing we should know about Prophet Ayyub. He was very, very patient. So let's start the story. A long, long time ago, there lived a man. His name was Ayyub, or some may call him Job. He loved Allah so very much, and Allah made him very wise. And he made him a very very rich man, and he had so many sons and daughters. Prophet Ayyub had many fields and lands. He was rich, and he had so many sheep. His house was very big. There were many servants in his house, and his children were very, very good. Prophet Ayyub knew that everything came from Allah, and he was very, very, very thankful. He was a very good man. He knew that Allah gave him fields and lands and cattle and sheep and money, and he prayed to Allah thanking him for the gifts. He always gave to the poor and the less fortunate. He was very, very generous. Shaitan was very surprised that Prophet Ayyub used to pray and thank Allah so much. And he was very jealous. But then he said, Shaitan said, it's easy for Ayyub to pray to Allah. Of course it is. It's easy for him to pray every day. He is rich. He has a lot of time. Of course he would thank Allah. If Ayyub was poor, if he didn't have beautiful houses and fields and lands, if Ayyub was poor, he would never love Allah so much. This is what they said. He would not pray all the time and be generous. Prophet Ayyub said that he did not eat anything without sharing it with the poor and orphans. Prophet Ayyub was very generous, but there were some people that used to say that if he had nothing, he would not pray to Allah. So Allah wanted to show that this was wrong. So he tested Prophet Ayyub. He wanted to show that Prophet Ayyub would never stop loving him. So, he put Prophet Ayyub to the test. One day, Prophet Ayyub's sheep were gone. The next day, all the water in the fields and the gardens dried up. And slowly, Prophet Ayyub became so poor. Slowly, Prophet Ayyub was losing all his properties and his wealth and his health and his family. His family members died too. That is very, very sad that his children died too. Prophet Ayyub was left all alone and he got sick. But Prophet Ayyub did not complain at all. He did not stop praying to Allah. He knew that Allah would help him and he trusted Allah. He praised Allah. He said, "I am overcome by distress. But you, my Lord, are the most merciful of all those that are merciful." Prophet Ayyub was the most patient. He was very, very patient and thankful. And Allah liked Prophet Ayyub's patience. He said to Ayyub, "Ayyub, strike your feet on the ground." And a spring of water gushed out. Allah commanded Prophet Ayyub. He said to Prophet Ayyub, "Ayyub, have a bath with this spring water and you will become healthy again." And guess what happened? Prophet Ayyub became well again. And Allah again gave him a big house. He gave him many fields and sheep. He gave him many children. He made him even more richer than before. Prophet Ayyub got back everything he had before and even more. Amazing. because Prophet Ayub had showed great patience throughout the worst of disasters and the worst of things that could have happened to him. Allah not only rewarded him with great bounty in the hereafter, but he also gave him double the amount in this world. How amazing is that? Prophet Ayub lived until a very, very old age, and he saw four generations. He became so rich, and it was said that it was rained upon him with locusts of gold. So what do we learn from this story, my children? You see, Allah loves those who are patient. Even if we have a lot, or if we have nothing at all, we should always, always, always be thankful and patient. It doesn't matter what you have, because we always have Allah, and that's the most important thing. And you are always, always lucky. You watching now, you are always lucky. I want you to look around you. Look around you now. Look around your house. See how many things you have. Look at how many things Allah has given to you. You are very, very lucky to have all these blessings. You are a very lucky boy and girl. And Allah has given it to you. Because you know, children, there are some people in the world who have nothing at all. So we have to be thankful. And we have to be patient. If we are patient, then Allah will give us more. So for today, instead of questions, I want you to do one thing. I want you to write down on the piece of paper 5 things that you are thankful for. 5 things that Allah has given you. And I want you to sit there and thank Allah for these things. It could be your family, it could be your parents, it could be something at your home. You think about it and you write it down, okay? 5 things. And then you can discuss this story of Prophet Ayub with your family, okay? Discuss this story with your mother and father. What did you learn from Prophet Ayub's story? Now, like we said, Prophet Ayub had everything, and he lost everything. Even his children died, and that's very, very sad. But Prophet Ayub believed and he trusted in Allah. Sometimes something sad may happen in our life, but then we must trust Allah, because Allah knows best. Okay, Prophet Ayub lost everything, his house and his money and his children, but he was patient and he thanked Allah. And guess what? Allah gave him more. And guess what? Allah granted him much more. And this is something we must always remember, okay? So, like I said, to end off today's video, I want you to get a pen and paper and write 5 things that you are thankful for. Look around your house and I'm sure you'll find many, many things, okay? So this is the story of Prophet Ayub, the patient one, the one who lost everything and was still patient and thankful, and Allah granted him back his health and his wealth. And this is a beautiful story that is mentioned in the Holy Quran. So if you once again want to open the Holy Quran, you will find this story. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed this story of Prophet Ayub. And if someone asks you, what is the story of Prophet Ayub? Then you will know exactly what happened to Prophet Ayub and his story. And you could say, Prophet Ayub is the patient one, the one who lost everything and still believed in Allah. So, inshallah, I'll be back tomorrow with another story for you all. So join me again tomorrow, okay? Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.